Hey guys, welcome to my channel and happy Monday. So today I just wanted to show you guys how I actually study. I know I'm like super up close and personal with this camera, and that's just because like the lighting, I'm just trying to work out the lighting right now. It's actually working pretty good, but once I put it over here, oh okay, that's a lot better. So I'm about to set you guys down and kind of show you guys how I like to study. Right now I'm just doing an elective course, so if you would like to see this video, go ahead and stick around. Okay, so what I'm taking right now is a sociology course. So what I do for every class, especially if it's a class for like language arts, if it's history, if it's sociology, psychology, that sort of thing, I go ahead and get a spiral notebook and I get a whole bunch of different colored pens. Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm just pulling up Blackboard. Usually I'll do this on my laptop, but I just have my iPad right now so I can kind of tell you or show you guys exactly what I'm doing. I'm going into the course, and what I'm just pulling up is like our syllabus. So I already know off the top of my head, but that's one thing that I like to check every single week is in every course to see what is due for this week. I didn't specify, but this is a completely online course. Of course, most courses with most or a lot of universities are online just because of COVID right now. So I go to my courses and I'm just gonna pull it up. And this week we have to do chapters 4 and 5. God, I can turn up the brightness. I have not filmed in so long. So this course is an accelerated course, and it's just because I started this course instead of the traditional 15 weeks in a semester, I'm doing 8 weeks. So this started later. It's not one unit course a week, it's actually two. So meaning we have to do 2 chapters a week, meaning we have to read the 2 chapters, watch all the videos, do all the exercises, and take quizzes for 2 chapters in a week. So again, every course is going to be a little bit different, but this professor is awesome because they give us the instructions and then you go to the lecture materials. So in the lecture materials, they have PowerPoint slides, videos to watch, flashcards to review, and a study guide. So because we get a study guide, which is great, I just read the chapter, and then with the reading, I'll follow along with the study guide. So for instance, it says define socialization. How does it occur? What are the primary ways of producing culture, and etc. So I'll just go through the chapter and answer the questions as I go along. And I like doing that this way because when it's time to do the unit exercises and the quizzes, I can just kind of go back and review all the information from here. And I'm just gonna show you guys what it actually looks like when I'm finished. So handwriting for it, I am left-handed, but anyways. So it's easy when you do it in different colors because it doesn't just bleed onto one page, and you can kind of, it kind of pops out. So again, I use different colors. Sometimes like what I did in chapter one, we were reviewing a lot of different sociologists. So everything about that person, even if it was on different lines, was in one color, just in case I needed to go back and reference a particular sociologist. I could do that and easily see everything about that person in one color. For instance, this is one sociologist right here, and this is everything that they accomplished, what their theory was about, and etc., what they believed in, and everything that way. So it was easy just to, for every sociologist, go back in that paragraph and see exactly a breakdown. So that's how I like to study. There might come a time when you may take a course that actually does not provide a study guide, and what I suggest is doing your own study guide. So before I got into the groove of how I was actually going to complete this course, I actually went and created my own study guide. So for like chapter one, I went ahead and everything that was important, I wrote down. So I wrote down everything, everything, everything. pretty much all the important information. I just followed along with the book and created my own. And then I noticed that there was a study guide, and the study guide was exactly what the guide to study was. So I went ahead and got hip to, I didn't need to do both. I can just do the study guide. But I remember a couple years ago when I took a psychology course that was in the classroom, and we had lecture and we had like PowerPoint and unit exercises, but on my own, I actually went and I did my own study guide. So I would actually do exactly what I just showed you guys on my own.
So that's another way that you can study.
Okay, so here's my beautiful setup. Not really, but it works. So I'll just have this up here. Sometimes what I'll do is I will go ahead and just screenshot from either my phone or from the tablet, just so that I can have a copy of the study guide in case, or you can print it out, but there's no need for me to print things that don't need to be printed. Just so that I can have a copy of it in case Blackboard logs me out. I don't have to continuously just log myself in just to see the study guide. Same thing with the PowerPoint. Sometimes I'll print those out, but from what I've been doing, it's just I'm screenshotting it that way. And then I will go ahead and start. Okay, so of course, do it how it makes sense to you and how you would like to study. But because it asks for the definition and then the next question was how does it occur, I just went right underneath it and then I made like an indentation and said it's an active process, and then continued with the question. And then it says, what are the primary ways of reproducing culture? So I'll also start that one, though in a different color, another indentation under that. So we're all still talking about socialization, but within that question, they're asking questions about it. Hopefully that makes sense. Sorry for the low lighting. My daughter is in the bed next to me. Hopefully she's about to take a nap. That'd be great. But anyways, I just completed one page and I just wanted to show you guys what that looks like exactly. So kind of looks like this. Gonna have bad handwriting, but when I'm looking at it, it's easy to decipher exactly what we're talking about, and it kind of makes studying a little bit easier. 6 different colored pens, and I just rotate them out, and it makes it so much easier when it's time to actually study. And also for like midterms and the final, I'll just have to review this information. I'm sure there'll probably be a study guide for that too, which will be great. But I can actually review it from this notepad that has all of the information on here in one easy place. And again, it's color coded, so it's easier for me to review and study. So that's how I like to study for pretty much every single class. Again, this is just an elective that some may choose while they're on their nursing journey. Some may choose other courses, but I decided that sociology is definitely something I'm interested in learning about, for one, and I can see me definitely needing it while being in the nursing field as a registered nurse. But at any rate, you guys, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, feel free to leave it in the comment box below. Don't forget to like this video, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.